Hey everybody, welcome back. This is Mr. Campbell from MrCampbellRocks.com here with another tutorial. Today we're going to show you how to add an image to a note or a list. And the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to start off with our desktop. Then we're going to move over to the iPad or the tablet. Then we're going to go to the mobile device, which is probably what most of you are going to do. The desktop version is very easy. What you're going to do is you're going to go to Google Keep, first of all, and you'll see these are all the Google Keeps that we've had previously in the tutorials. And what I'm going to do is I have an empty note here, right? I'm just going to delete this so you can see if I want to add a new one. Right up here where it says take a note, I want to add an image here. So a new note with an image. And the minute I click on that image, what it's going to do is it's going to basically go to my files, either my desktop or iCloud. I'm going to go to my desktop and grab an image of a screenshot that I took earlier today when I was working on a website. So once you have that selected, you'll just click open. Again, this could be any sort of image file. It could be a PNG, a JPEG, the screenshot if you're on a Mac or a PC or a clip or something like that. So I'm gonna click on open. You'll see that it's going to pull into my Google Keep. While it's uploading, I'm going to just give this a title here. And what you'll see here is that it basically pulls in this. We're actually gonna come back to this a little bit later because this is how you can create headings for some of your Google Keep categories or labels. But this is an image from your computer. So next what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna slide over and you're going to see my iPad and how we upload an image from an iPad. And there's a lot of different ways you can do this from mobile devices, whether that's an iPad or a tablet or a phone. So that'll take a little bit more time. So once we slide over here, you can see that I'm on my home screen on the iPad. What you're going to have to do if you want to allow Keep to basically pull images or audio is you're going to have to allow Keep to do that. And so what you'll do is you'll go to settings and you'll see that I already have allow Google Keep to access. So it's actually going to access my location, my photos. But what I also want it to do is I wanted to give it access to my microphone and my camera. And what this allows Google Keep to do as soon as I take a picture or if it goes into my photos, I can pull photos from there or I can take one live straight from my camera, my camera roll, or I can do the screenshot on the iPad or other mobile devices. So once we have that set up, we're gonna go back to Google Keep. And you'll see here that I have my Google Keep account connected. So this is the image that we just took from the computer. And on the iPad, it's a little bit different. It's down here on the lower left, right down here. So I'm gonna click on that little image and it's gonna ask me if I wanna take a photo or choose an image. And we're gonna do both. So I'm gonna take a photo and you'll see that it'll pull up my computer screen. We're gonna get super meta here. So we'll just take a picture of this little bowl that we've got on our table, a bunch of 4th of July stuff right there. I'm gonna use this photo. And then you'll see that that automatically will go right in. So again, if we go down, we click on the little picture right down here. We're actually gonna choose an image and what it'll do is it'll pull all of our photos. So we'll go all photos, most recent, right? This is my daughter last night as we were watching fireworks across the street. And we've got our glow-in-the-dark sunglasses there. So this is from my camera roll. Again, I can add a note here. And then you'll see that the Keep is there. That photo is there. Now, if we slide over, I'm gonna move the iPad out of the way and we're gonna slide over just a little bit to the left. And you'll see there's my phone. So when we open up Keep, so let me go to my home screen. So I go to Google and I have Keep Notes here. You'll see that those notes are already there. We have a couple different ways that we can do this. We can always hit the plus sign, right? If we want to take a note here, and then we can hit that other plus sign and we can add an image or take a photo. The other thing that we can do is you'll see right down here, I can actually grab a photo. So there's a couple different options here. I can add an image from my actual camera. So let's say I'm at a conference or I'm in class or I want to send notes home to kids. This is what's amazing about this, right? If you're using Reminder, anything else. But I can take a photo of the notes on my screen. So here's our kitchen again. Let's say I'm done with the end of the day. I take notes, right? I click OK. And again, imagine this is notes. Notes for today. If I wanted to, and we'll get into this in more details, I could add a collaborator to this note later, and I could share this with the students that weren't there that day. So there's that. I can actually also grab an image from my camera roll. So here's some more fireworks from last night. And let's add that. So the other thing that I can do is I can actually grab a screenshot. So if I'm just on my blank screen right here, and this is what's awesome about this, is let's say I take some notes or I have something that I already have on my phone and I just do my screenshot button, it'll pull up the image right there. I can click on share. And what it'll do is it'll pull up all of the things that I can share my picture with. So if I click on keep notes, you'll see down at the bottom here, I have which account I wanna share this with. So instead of my school account, I want to share it with Mr. Campbell Rocks. That's what we're using here. I'm going to click on save, and you'll see that it says save to Google Keep. If I go back into Keep, there's that screenshot that I just took on my phone. So there are three or four ways that you can take Keep on your phone. There are two or three different ways that you can take it on an iPad or a tablet, and there's one way that you can do it on a computer. Thank you for watching this video all the way till the end, and thank you for what you do for kids on a daily basis. If this video saved you time, energy, and frustration, go ahead and like, subscribe, and share it with your teacher friends. You can subscribe by clicking up here, or you can watch another video either here or here. Again, I love you, I appreciate you, and I'm glad that you're here.